Florida Gators, a team we played, of course, last year. I think we played them twice last year. So we get a chance to go down and play against in Gainesville. They lost their first conference game, I think, on the road at Mississippi Ole Miss, which tells you, again, how competitive this league is. And every game is a big game. So we're looking forward to the opportunity to go out and play a lot better than the last time we played on the road. Hopefully go out and play with great energy. I thought the Missouri game, we came out with great energy defensively, and I thought it got us into some offense transition-wise. And then I thought that last two minutes and 30-some-odd seconds, I thought was some of our better defense. I mean, we didn't let them score. Missouri, they had a couple of shots, but they were contested shots. And I just thought our defense, our energy was totally different. And you're going to need that on the road. But even more so on the road, you got to make shots. You got to be able to make shots. You got to withstand, you know, their runs. They're a team that really shoots the basketball well. What concerns me, they shoot the ball from the perimeter really, really well. And Chioza is a kid that can get in there and make things happen for them. Allen, of course, a young man from this area here. They have a fifth-year senior, a kid transferred in from Rice. He's playing really, really well for them. And, of course, Jalen Hudson, someone we're familiar with. So the Hayes kid, the Stone kid. So, again, Mike White has those kids. They're starting to play, get back that edge. And he lost a couple of games early on, but we can see in conference play they're playing awful well. So great opportunity, another challenge.
Yeah, Mike, I guess Daryl had four assists on four of your last six baskets the other day. He had eight for the game for the fourth time. He's got almost as many assists now as he did all last season. I think just 10 or 11 fewer. Just what have you thought about his development as a playmaker and as an assist guy?
I think he's developing as a player. I thought even his defense was probably the best it's been the other night. But he's played the game the right way, played with purpose, played with passion, played to win. I think that's the biggest key, played to win. And obviously we know he can score. But I think when a guy can make others better, that makes him even a much more special player, more attractive player when you have the all-around game. And I thought he had some passes that were not assists, that led to the assist, the long passes down the, you know, down the floor that gave another guy an opportunity. So that just tells me the continued development. And that's what our guys do. Our guys develop in year two, and we need him to play at a high level. The most impact you can have on a team when you're not scoring, what can you do to help the team? What can you do to help the team? And that's the thing I want to resonate with our guys. If you're not scoring, can you make others better? And I think we're starting to see that. And you want to do it in big moments. And he did it in some big moments the other night.
CJ got 12 minutes on Saturday and didn't record a stat. And he's been kind of struggling with his shot lately. Do you think he's just trying too hard, or what
Pressing
do you think?
A bit. Probably. It'll happen. I think it'll happen. Yes, that's young players for you. You know, hopefully we can get him to the free throw line or get out in transition. He had an opportunity to score, you know, some buckets there in the game. A layup he missed, but it ain't because he's not trying. I think he did some good things defensively, and he spilled some guys some minutes where they can get some rest to go back out there, and you know, hopefully his time will be to shine is will be on this road.
Darius, you think you'll continue with him in the starting lineup, and do you bring Daryl off the bench or somebody else off the bench?
We'll see. We'll see how that goes. Again, I just think, you know, game by game, I got about 7-8 starters, and so we'll see what takes place in practice, and then we'll move forward to the game. I think no matter where he comes from, where he plays from, he's going to give us that kind of energy, that kind of play with a sense of urgency. And that's what I'm looking for, the sense of urgency, and I saw it in our whole team.
Coach, are there specific combinations of your forwards that you've liked so far, or are you kind of just playing it by the situation?
Is there a combination of what now?
Of your forwards.
Forwards?
Yeah.
I've got some guys that, you know, I'm looking for consistency with them. I thought Dustin Thomas the other night, I thought he played real well. Dustin does a lot of things that goes unnoticed. He does a lot of the dirty work for us. He took some charges, fixed a lot of things on defense in terms of the rotation, rotating out on the guard to keep penetration from taking place. he does a lot of good things. And, you know, and then, of course, I think Cook, he gives you another guy dimension on the press. I think he's really good on the press in terms of fixing things on defense. We finally seen him getting the ball out in transition and making a pass. He made a nice little pass to Darius Hall, cutting to the hole. So I think the more they play, the more you see some of the things they bring to the table. And obviously, Trey has a great basketball IQ, and we saw it on display the other night, and we saw him go and use his size and get some offensive rebounds and putting them back in there. So they just got to keep bringing it. You know, it's kind of like, you know, on any given night, one of them can have a big night, but I want them to be consistent in their effort.
Mike, I think Florida is the only road venue in the SEC where you haven't won since you've been back. And it's been 95 since Arkansas won down there. I mean, how tough a stretch has that been? Is that just kind of hard to believe, even as good as Florida has been, that Arkansas hadn't won down there in over 20 years?
Well, I just, you know, they've done what they're supposed to do. They take care of the home. You know, when Billy was there, his teams, you know, he has some phenomenal teams, and they played well there. And of course, since we've been here, we've had some opportunities and just couldn't finish it. So let's hope this will be the time we can finish it. It's all about having a chance to finish and be in the game. You want to hang around and hang around. So the things you got to do, you got to shoot the basketball, you got to defend, you got to get to the free throw line, and you got to make free throws, and you can't turn the ball over. They're a team that if you turn it over, you take a bad shot, they will make you pay for it. Their transition offense is, and they're very explosive there, you know, because they got so many guys that are capable. Every guy on their team is capable of knocking down a three-point shot. So, again, our transition defense got to be on point. We got to keep them off the offensive boards, and we got to keep those runs as minimum as we possibly can, and get our own runs, make our own runs with our defense.
Coach, the TV broadcast kind of picked up a moment early in the first half with you and Darius. You're kind of checking. You asked him, I think, where his heart was, and how valuable can those little moments be for a young guy like him?
I think it's calming him down. Basically, it was. You know, I was trying to be funny, really. I thought I was a little funny about it, but that's how he took it. I think he took it like that because he looked at me like, "Coach, are you tripping? Are you crazy?" And so it just one of those moments. I think it's it speaks volume to him. I think because he took it the right way.
Coach, obviously non-conference and SEC play are a lot different. How have you seen Daniel adapt his game and improve his game since the start of SEC play?
Well, you know, early on, you know, he was one of those guys that not a whole lot of people knew about. They knew about reading his biography and where he's from and all that. And then he had some games where he played real well. And, of course, now he's on the scouting report. And so now going to conference play, we know the urgency goes up about 10 notches, the physicality goes up, the speed of the game goes up. And you're that guy that's probably number one on their scouting report. And I think as this is game, we play five games, and I think he's starting to try to make that adjustment. We got to help him, though. And how do we help him? We got to, number one, put him in position where he have a chance to be successful. And he's got to continue to do the things that he's been doing to keep him successful. One of the things, he's a guy of size that can run the floor. He's pretty agile. He can come out on the floor and put him, you know, where he ain't just a strictly power basketball player. Get some transition baskets. Get better at the free throw line because he's going to get a foul a lot. He's a tremendous offensive rebounder. Very much like Bobby was like that. A great offensive rebounder. Uses his length and athletic ability. And I think he's playing a lot taller now than he was early in the year. So, but I think the strength factor is really, really big, and the physicality of the game. He's starting to adjust.
Are some of the offensive struggles you've had in conference play due to defense, or is it something else that maybe is going on with the inability to score points in games?
Well, if you look at what's taking place, I think number one is we're not getting enough shots up. So that means, you know, our transition offense, when we push the ball and get right into our offense, I think we're able to get, you know, quality shots, or we get attacks to the baskets. The other night, we shot 20-some-odd free throws, and we made 12. I mean, that's 10 to 12 points right there easily. We missed some easy layups. Anton had a momentum layup, so we missed some momentum plays, and it allowed Missouri to hang around, and it actually took a lead. But I think the shots have started falling. I think we got to get into the point where we get easier shots. Continue to start inside out. I think that's the biggest key. Just making the right decisions.
With the free throws, because even some of your best free throw shooters from last year struggling right now, just anything you can put your finger on as to what the problem is? With
no, just got to keep working on them, and, you know, you don't harp on them, but you got to put time in on it. I think you got to put time in on it. So, and we do. We do that. So hopefully those guys, you know, free throws are personal. You got to get in there. You got to really work on it. And we spend a lot of time, you know, on free throws, but they've got to do some things on their own as well. And we put in different situations, scenarios, games, so they can work on it. But they've got to go out there and just have the calmness to go in and make them, Nate. That's all.
Hey, Mike, this is a start of a stretch of four of your next five SEC games are on the road. You got the Oklahoma State here, but before your next five conference games are on the road, maybe you guys have had a stretch like that. I can't remember, but how tough is that when you got four of your next five on the road in the league?
It's the way the schedule is written. I didn't even look that far, so thanks for reminding me, Bob. But we're in a race, and you got to have nine games at home, you have nine on the road, and that's in my mindset. We knew that at the beginning, and so the games will come, and we got to play them. So whether it be at home or on the road, we just got to continue to build consistency and get better. I always talk about, our team getting better, and I want to see us get better from each time we go out and play. And it tells you a lot more about your basketball team when you go out on the road. You find out a whole lot about your team. And so as we get ready to go down and play Florida, we'll find out. And then the next game after that, and the next game after that. So, but hopefully, like I said, we just get better from it.
Last one about the Kayvon, struggling. He's only averaging a little over 6 points in league play, shooting under 35%. What have you seen from him? You kind of surprised with the career he's had that he's struggling scoring and shooting like he has been?
Well, we got some guys that are struggling, and so it don't surprise me. Again, you go from the sometimes right on to the top of the scouting report. You look at some of the guys they had last year. It makes it easier for other guys to score. But he's very capable of that, and you know that. And as a coach, I know that. So I don't know what is contributing, just maybe not shooting the ball well. But that can turn like a switch, man. You turn that switch on, the guy just goes off. So let's hope in this game here. But he's a very, very good basketball player.
Thank you.